Assalamualaikum to Madam Offline everyone. Have a good day. My name is Nur Husna Binti Shahrum from JBC 2492B. Today, I'm looking forward to talk with you about Malaysia economy during COVID-19. The first COVID-19 case that have been detected in Malaysia was on 24 January 2020 with a total of 22 cases coming from 12 people who travel abroad, 8 people had close contact and 2 people from humanitarian missions. Since the pandemic occurred, gross domestic product declined drastically in the fourth quarter of 2020 by 5.6%, which is the largest contraction since 1998. The unemployment showing a sharp increase that reached to 5.3% in May 2020 showed that this crisis had impacted Malaysia. However, after cash subsidy and the government allowed business to operate as usual, the employment rate dropped and reached 4.7% through March 2021. Furthermore, the foreign exchange rate can also be a measure of where economy is standing. In March 2019, the Malaysian exchange rate was RM18 for 1 USD and its value has decreased to RM26 since July 2020. It has increased to RM5 for 1 USD in May 2021. The leakage trade rate will conduct to cause push inflation since cost of imported raw materials are increasing. Does government give any incentive during this pandemic? Our Prime Minister has announced initiative under National Economic Recovery Plan worth $35 billion and numerous initiatives under Economic Stimulus Package to cushion Malaysians from economic fallout. Want to know what government provide for us during pandemic? Let's check it out. For individual, in payments of people carrying assistance, people get EPF account 1 withdrawal with 500% per month. Eligible EPF members will be able to withdraw money from their account 1 through the iSenior facility. We also get EPF account 2 withdrawal for life, illness insurance and housing. Younger generation of Malaysia also receive laptop for 150,000 students which will help them going through online classes. Daily meat supply amounted 420 million for students and e-wallet for youth aged 18 to 20 and full-time students to encourage them buy things that are necessary. That are incentive for individual. How about industry? Allocation for SMEs are 100 billion deferment loan payment for 6 months which targeted to help SMEs save up their money as no interest be applied on loan. Next, special tax relief amounted 5 million. There will be a tax deduction for expenses incurred in the refurbishment of business premises. SMEs also provided with 6.8 billion for all economic sector facility. Tourism industry is one of the most important industry in Malaysia economy. Incentive that is given to them are bus and taxi hire purchase rehabilitation scheme with an allocation of 1 billion ringgit. Through this scheme, eligible bus and taxi operators can get a loan moratorium period extended to 36 months. After Klang Valley and Selangor, the MyTT Unlimited Travel Pass has been expanded to include Rapid Penang and Rapid Kuantan bus networks. There will be 6 million leave exemption provided by Human Resource Development for companies in tourism sector. Oh, government? No worries, government also received incentives such as for Ministry of Health, government has provided 1 billion for COVID-19 aid which can be used to enforce medical equipment. 600 ringgit were also given to civil servants of Ministry of Health and one-off payment amounting 500 ringgit were provided for all medical frontliners. For Ministry of Domestic Trade, the cooking oil stabilization scheme was implemented amounting 400 million due to higher crude palm oil price. Furthermore, 200 million were implied regarding to Malaysian product purchase program. This will stimulate domestic economic growth by increasing the purchase of local goods. What are the results of the incentive being applied? For government, condition of economy is to be relaxed and hospitality especially for COVID-19 cases receive adequate facilities. For industry, we can see that SMEs may increase their involvement in key sectors. Industry also revive the economy through tourism sector. Lastly, for the pupils, this incentive had helped to enhance well-being of citizens from youth to senior citizens. Now, the people are assisted to the production of digital work and content, career opportunities and skill development programs. So that's all from me. Stay safe, wear a mask, follow social distancing. Take care. Bye. Assalamualaikum.